Hello everyone, this is Yana Smakula for W+9 and thank you for joining me today. In this video, I will show you how to quickly stamp a custom pattern for a birthday card using images from the Big Deal and Big Deal Editions stamp set. And I'll also show you how to easily watercolor them using wet on wet technique. Whenever I plan to stamp a pattern for my card, I like to do test stamping first onto a piece of printer paper. Here is a test pattern I stamped for this card. I picked three images, a hippo, a lion, and a unicycle, and stamped them repeatedly in the same order in black ink. You can easily stamp patterns like this using a variety of images. For a pattern like this, I would recommend you go with images that are about the same size. The line here is a little bit taller, but not too much to distort my pattern. I aligned my images on a clear block, I mounted them all at once, and stamped them all at once to save time. Here is another pattern, or another example of a pattern you can create using images, other images from W+9. I used critters from the Bunny Masquerade stamp set here, and positioned them in two different ways to create two slightly different patterns. Depending on how you want to color your pattern later, you'll need to pick appropriate type of paper and appropriate type of ink for your stamping. I will be coloring my images using watercolors, so I'm using watercolor paper and VersaFine Onyx Black ink, which is a waterproof ink. Since these images aren't big, they aren't tiny, but they're not very large either, I'm going to heat emboss them in clear embossing powder to make watercolor process go a little bit faster. The raised embossed edge of these images will serve as a barrier when I go to watercolor different sections of my critters and will allow me to color them faster. I like to start my stamping somewhat in the center of my panel and move out. I'm using Arches Hot Press watercolor paper today. I love Arches paper and I usually prefer to use cold pressed paper as it has some texture to it. But because I'm doing stamping today and I'm not using a stamping tool but rather a clear block, I'm using hot pressed paper, which is smooth and is perfect for stamping. I did not have to double stamp any of my images and was able to get great stamped results just from a single impression. Next, I'm covering this with clear embossing powder, and I'm going to heat set it with my heat tool to melt the powder. If you're not into coloring, you can heat emboss or stamp this pattern onto colored cardstock, or maybe even strips of colored cardstock, and have a colorful background composed of colored cardstock blocks and maybe white or black stamped images. So you don't have to color this pattern if you do not enjoy coloring. I do enjoy coloring process, so I'm going to color my images using Daniel Smith watercolors. I have this sample dot chart with a bunch of different colors, and I'm going to use just a tiny bit of watercolors from here to color my images. I'm starting with a hippo and first wetting this image using my water brush. I love to do wet on wet technique as it does all the work for you. What this means is you need to wet the image you plan to color first, and next come in and drop color into the sections you want to be darkest on your finished image. The water will do all the work for you and will move the watercolor pigment and will help it travel to the other areas of your image, creating a soft transition. So here I used graphite gray color to color my hippo and I added color just to the darkest sections and then let the water take the pigment to the lighter sections and also used my brush to help it move a little bit better. Another way I like to do the wet on wet technique is I like to lay a very soft layer of color together with my water. So not only add water, but mix it in with some color for a base coat. And then I come in and drop in the pigment, the darker pigment that I want to use for the shadow areas on my image. Please know that I'm in no way a watercolor expert. I just love to play a little bit, and this is one of the tricks that I like using in my coloring. Finally, to color the unicycle, I'm using the same approach and coloring it in pink. You can easily make this into a guy card by coloring the bike blue or green. I'm also going to add some blush to my hippos. I'm using very light pink here. And also going to add a little bit of shading under my images to somehow ground them on this pattern. Right now, they look like they're floating in the air, but I'd rather they were standing on something. After my coloring was done, I trimmed my panel and adhered it onto an A2 tough folding card base. I also added a white heat embossed sentiment that reads, "Birthday wishes to the greatest person on earth," and added black enamel dots to complete this project. I encourage you to pick a few critter images of similar size and stamp a quick pattern. Color it or go with colored cardstock instead, and just have fun creating. So this finishes my today's video. I hope I have given you some new ideas to try and explore. Have fun, play a little bit, and enjoy. Thank you so much for joining me today. Be sure to check out W+9 for more creative inspiration. See you next time. Bye!